the new Elections Act, if you can call it that way, the one that was amended after the Joint Parliamentary Select Committee report on electoral reforms, requires that six months before an election, the IEBC should subject the voter register to an audit. And for the purposes of this first election after the enactment of this law, they are supposed to do this within 30 days, to start the audit within 30 days. And so the calendar of events runs to January. And you know, our elections are in August. So that takes it to the 6 months, which is the 6 months starting on February 8th. The purpose of the audit is basically the election is about the voter register. The integrity of the voter register weighs a lot on the elections. This is why during the last election, one of the arguments by the CORD coalition while challenging the election of President Uhuru Kenyatta was that there were numerous voter registers, whereas even to some extent where they were saying some dead voters voted. And you see, IEBC has said that we have a systematic problem in the country where we have registers like the death register. It's not probably up to date. That data they don't have. And so clean up the register becomes a nightmare, because for them they are required by law to first add all those who have gotten IDs into the register. Secondly, they're supposed to clean up the register of dead people. The other thing they're supposed to do is to ensure that there are no double registrations. That's why the voter register has to be subjected to verification. And you have to go and verify if your name is there, or your name matches your ID, or the polling station that you actually registered in. And so those are some of the reasons why the register needs to be audited. But the main issue is about the credibility of the entire election, which is based on the voter register. As I've mentioned earlier, IEBC may not have all the information needed to clean up the register, such as the issue of the deaths. You see, deaths are registered by a different organization. That's the National Bureau of Registration. We also have a situation where the IEBC does not have enough staff to do this kind of work. You see, the IEBC has around 900 staff. Their main business is electoral management, and that's the management of elections. And so we have specialists who can deal with this issue. And that's why the law now requires them to look for a firm or a firm of certain years of experience who can be able to have done this and can be able to clean it up. So IEBC itself may lack the capacity, and because they don't know who has died. then they know who is registered, or whoever comes, the new person who comes to be registered. All they can clean up is the issue of double registration, where someone may have registered twice, probably in Nakuru or in Eldoret, and that can be captured by the system, because the system basically is biometric. The only issue that affects the current commissioners carrying out the audit is the political reasons given by the opposition. These people are said to lack credibility, people don't have confidence in them, and that's why they have resigned. But at the end of the day, this is a very key institution for our democracy. There cannot be a vacuum. And also, time is not waiting. For instance, the earliest we can get the new commissioners is probably mid-November, end of December. We cannot wait until then for this process to start. Because first and foremost, the law actually says 30 days. That is it. 30 days expire on November 4th. So at the end of the day, I don't think it's just an issue of how do the current commissioners drive this process in a way that they are seen to be open with the entire process. For instance, when they recruit this particular company or firm that they have advertised for, will we have people challenging the credibility of that particular company? You see, those are some of the issues that may come up. But basically, in terms of IEBC as an institution, IEBC as an institution should be led to do the job, whether these commissioners are the ones doing it or the others are coming, because we cannot have a vacuum. That's why they remain in office until these other guys are sworn in. Because, for instance, we have like the by-elections on October 29th. We have to have commissioners supervising these elections. And so if we don't have a new commission, we cannot say that we won't have by-elections. Yeah, so those are some of the issues. So the issue of whether or not they cannot do it is just political. It's nothing, has nothing to do with the institution or the management of elections as a whole.